Why you ever chose me has always been a mystery. All my life I've been told I belong at the end of the line with all the other not quite, with all the never get it right. But it turns out they're the ones you were looking for all this time.
Dear Father, we pray for peace in our world and an end to war. Instead of hatred, let there be love. Shelter your children and protect us. Guide us and keep us from harm so we can build our world of love and live our lives in peace. Amen.
Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before him with joyful songs. Know that the Lord is God. It is he who made us, and we are his. We are his people, the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and praise his name. For the Lord is good, and his love endures forever. His faithfulness continues through all generations.
Well, good morning, boys and girls. It's lovely to see you. Today, we're going to be thinking about the word special. Now, I'm not going to tell you a story because later on, Fiona and Marianne are going to be telling you a story about people from the Bible who were very special. They were very ordinary, but they were very special to God. Now, because I was an infant teacher all my life, and infant teachers are not as clever as secondary school teachers, or they're not as clever as ministers, I thought I would look up the meaning of the word special in the dictionary. Do you know what a dictionary is, boys and girls? Can you tell us? Tell the big people what a dictionary is, because they may not know. Emma? Good girl. Yes, a dictionary tells us the meaning of words. So I looked up the meaning of the word special, and there were lots of meanings, but the two I really liked was important and extraordinary. What do you think special means? Can any of the boys and girls tell us what special, what you think special means? Lucy? You've got special gloves. These are lovely gloves, and they're very special to you, yes. Can any of the older children tell us what special means? Grace? No? Say that again. When you have something you really, really like, that's special to you. Can you think of anywhere where you might have seen the word special? At home, or in the supermarket, or in school? Catherine? That's right, you read about special in the Bible when we read about God and about Jesus. Grace? I think you were reading my notes. That's what I was going to say. We see the word special in supermarkets if there's a special offer. And if I see a special offer for chocolate, who do you think always buys it? Me, yes, me. Now, some people think that to be special, you've got to be a famous footballer or a famous pop star or a TV star. But boys and girls, I want to tell you that that's not really true, because you are all special. Every single one of you are special. I know you're special to your mums and dads. You're special to your families. You're special to your church family. All the people here today think you're special. But more importantly, you are special to God. Now, I said I wasn't going to tell a story, and I'm just going to tell a very, very, very short one. When I went to visit my sister in Thailand once, we went to visit some people who had leprosy. Now, leprosy is not a very nice illness. It can eat away at your fingers and your toes and even at your face. And we went to visit a man called Mr. Lamut, and he wasn't nice to look at because leprosy had eaten away part of his face. But do you know this? When we went to visit him, he was all smiles and so happy. And when Sandra asked him why he was smiling, he said, "I've just read in the Bible that I am special to God. It doesn't matter what I look like. It doesn't matter what people think when they look at me and see all this marks in my face. I am special to God." And I thought that was absolutely wonderful. Mr. Lamoot is special to God. You are all special to God. We're all special to God. And you are so special that God sent his son Jesus to come into the world to let you know how special you are, and to let you know that he loves you and will always, always care for you. So will you remember that, boys and girls? Remember that when you don't feel special, if your friends are not speaking to you, or you're worried about your homework or worried about schoolwork, remember that God loves you and he's always there and he'll listen to you and help you because you are special.
Can you think of anybody special that people all know about? God, yes. Any human being that everybody knows about? Family members, true. But does everybody know about your family members? They're famous, aren't they? Joe, now you know, you're famous. Yeah, you've got mum and dad, they're special, aren't they? Yeah, that's right. But there are other people that people think are special, folks like Andy Murray, Boris Johnson, Mr. Putin, that thinks himself very special. Can you think of somebody special and we don't know his name or her name? Can you think of anybody? Who? We know his name, don't we? His name's Jesus. But can you think of anybody that was special that we just don't know their name? Well, I'm going to mention two. And that song that we just listened to, actually, it struck a chord with me, although I didn't choose it. Because we're talking about people, we don't know their names. The first one is in Mark chapter 5. Jesus was busy teaching lots of people down by the shore when a dad came to him and said, "My daughter's terribly sick. Can you come and make her better? Can you come and heal her? Because we think she's going to die." Now, it took them a while to get back to his house, and by the time they got back there, she had died. And everybody was terribly, terribly upset. But Jesus brought her back to life. And you know, we don't know her name. We don't know her name at all. But everybody in the village where she lived would have known that she was the girl that Jesus brought back to life. Even though, and the story tells us about how special Jesus was. The other person I'm thinking of was a young boy. And you know, at the time of Jesus, boys and girls and women weren't counted when you had a crowd of people. So in fact, if you went round this church today, you'd have 19 people. Now there are lots more than that, aren't there? Yeah, there's lots more than that because there are ladies and there are children. And there is a passage in the book of John. And it was in John chapter 6. Now, Jesus was busy teaching people. And he'd been doing it for such a long time, everybody was hungry. And he said to his disciples, go and feed them. But they didn't have any food. But somebody did. Can you remember who had the food? Oh, you had some Weetabix today. Good. Well done. Did you share it with anybody? You had it all yourself. That was the right thing to do. Yeah, because I think your granny would have been upset if you'd shared your Weetabix. Jesus didn't have the food with him. And God at the time didn't have the food. It was a little boy who had the food. And we don't know his name again. And he wasn't counted in the number of people that were there. But he had some loaves and fishes. And there were 5,000 men there. Now, as I said, they just counted the men. So there were lots and lots of women and lots of boys and girls there as well. So there were thousands of people there. I don't think we've got 1,000 here in the church. But do you think your packed lunch would feed everybody here? Don't think so. But you know, this young boy, he was prepared to give his lunch to Jesus, even though he was probably hungry as well as everybody else. And you remember what Jesus did? Jesus took the packed lunch and he prayed and asked God to bless it. And then he asked his disciples to pass it round. Now, how far do you think the packed lunch would go round 5,000 men and lots of boys and girls and women as well? In ordinary circumstances, it wouldn't. But Jesus was able to feed all these people. What do you think your mum and dad would say if you went home from school and said that your teacher had taken your packed lunch and fed everybody? Yes, they wouldn't believe you, you're right. But the people had learned that Jesus could do special things because he was special. And you know, it's important that even though we might not think we're important, if we give something to Jesus, he can do special things with it. So if we give our time, if we give our money, and if we share our packed lunch with somebody, we're giving it to Jesus, and Jesus can do something very special. We can't do it by ourselves, but he can. Okay? And that makes us special. The boys and the girls and the ladies are just as special as the men in this place. Okay?
Why you ever chose me has always been a mystery. All my life I've been told I belong at the end of the line with all the other not quite, with all the never get it right. But it turns out they're the ones you were looking for all this time. 'Cause I'm just a nobody trying to tell everybody all about somebody who saved my soul. Ever since you rescued me, you gave my heart a song to sing. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus. When Moses had stage fright and David brought a rock to a sword fight, you picked 12 outsiders nobody would have chosen, and you changed the world. Well, the moral of the story is everybody's got a purpose. So when I hear that devil start talking to me, saying, who do you think you are? I say, I'm just a nobody trying to tell everybody all about somebody who saved my soul.
for the world to see, nobody but Jesus. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus.
So let me go down, down, down in history as another blood-bought faithful member of the family. And if they all forget my name, well, that's fine with me. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus. So let me go down, down, down in history.
Go down in history.
As another blood-bought, faithful member of the family.
That's all I ever wanna be.
And if they all forget my name, well, that's fine with me. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus.
I'm just a nobody,
nobody,
trying to tell everybody all about somebody.
Ooh,
who saved my soul. Ever since you rescued me, you gave my heart a song to sing. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus. I'm living for the world to see, nobody but Jesus. Nobody but Jesus.
And now the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and forevermore.